How many of you use Docker in production environment? Good. I will give you a brief introduction about Docker and quickly switch to the scalable part. So having Docker experience will be a plus for you, but don't worry. I will give you the fancy comments about the Docker and related technologies during the session, and we have a demo at the end of the session. We will have a great time, I think. Who am I, actually? I am a full-stack software engineer currently working for the Gitti Gidiyor, which is a eBay division located in Turkey. You can see me while contributing on stackoverflow.com, and I am writing article for Java Code Geeks and Envato Tools Plus about software developments and DevOps engineering. Sometimes I review books about software development. You can see the last book I reviewed about Node.js and related technologies already published on Tech Publishing. The technologies used in software development world growing very fast, especially in last decade. We are the developers also use fancy technologies about software development, like we are using microservice architecture, we are using NoSQL database solution instead of relational databases. It is very easy to use big data analysis tools like Hadoop, Mahout, or Apache Kafka. But when it comes to deployment and system administration part, we are kind of unfamiliar with it. But why? You are the one who writes the code, but why another person deploys your code? Wouldn't it be better if you decide how much RAM will be required for your application? Or wouldn't it be better if you decide how many members will be exist in your cluster, entire cluster? Docker will help us on this thing. I think that we must take the control of the entire structure of the software development lifecycle. So what is Docker? Docker lets you to package your application with its dependencies like code you have written, runtime, and system libraries inside one container. So what is my aim here to put all the dependencies on the, into one container is that, for example, let's say that you are developing Spring Boot application. You need to include Java, Spring dependencies, and the code you have already written inside one container in order to run that container on every place you want, every place the Docker daemon already have installed in. But containerization technology is not a new thing. We are hearing about the containerization technology since 2004, I think, with the open source Virtuoso and then Jails. Also, Alexi containers that is already embedded in the Linux kernel. We are also using virtual machines, but why Docker? Why we are using Docker for, why Docker is very best technology for software developer like us? In order to continue, let's compare the virtual machine and the Docker one by one. We have two infrastructures, same infrastructure, for the virtual machines technology and the Docker. For virtual machines, we have host operating systems, and the, for the Docker, we have operating system. This layer is very important. If you are using VirtualBox, VirtualBox is a hypervisor itself. And in Docker part, we have Docker engine. Let's say that you want to install three different guest operation systems, Ubuntu, SUSE, and Fedora, in your computer. When you use VirtualBox, for example, to install those operating systems, VirtualBox will duplicate the same Linux kernel for each operating system. And then bins and libs folders will be included at the top of this operating system. So this means distribution, actually. This is one distribution. This is another kind of Linux distribution. Actually, all the distribution have same Linux kernel inside it. But why we are not sharing the Linux kernel beside these operating system. So Docker says that we have same Linux kernel, so I can share the Linux kernel between the containers, not guest operating system. This time we have the containers, and distribution differs from each other by their bins and libs folder. And finally, we are including our applications at the top of these operating systems, and on Docker side, we have applications inside the containers. This is the main difference between Docker and the virtual machines, but we have lots of advantages for the Docker side, and we will see those advantages in the next slides. Those are the theoretical information about Docker, but the main reason of this session is the related technologies in order to set up a scalable system. Our first technology is Docker Machine, and Docker Machine lets you to create a Docker host and specific client to connect Docker on your local computer, on cloud providers, even in your own data center. What does it mean? If you want to create machine, machine means if you want to create Docker machine, you can use Docker machine to create it every place you want. You can see a sample command on the screen. Docker machine create command create a virtual machine for you, and it takes additional two parameters. The first one is the driver. -D VirtualBox here means that I am going to create a machine that uses VirtualBox driver. It will create me a VirtualBox machine. The second parameter is the name of your machine. When you execute this command, you will actually see this one on the VirtualBox dashboard. So I think you are very familiar with this stuff. So we are able to create machines, so it does not seem very hard. Let's switch to another technology that is Docker Swarm. We are able to create multiple machines, right? We have the Docker machine, and we are able to create multiple machines every place you want. For example, I created the machine in my local computer, but if you want to create Docker virtual machines in any cloud providers like AWS, DigitalOcean, or Azure, you can create that machines inside your local laptop. But whenever you wanna communicate that machines between each other, you need to use another technology called Docker Swarm. Docker Swarm is native clustering tool developed by Docker team. You can see a sample command on the screen in order to create boilerplate Swarm cluster. This is actually Docker run Swarm command. It's actually for running a container called Swarm. There is an image called Swarm, and I am simply running that image in order to run container, and I am executing the command that belongs to the Swarm. This will create a boilerplate cluster and will be returning me a token ID. If you have ever used or set up a clustering system, you will already know that in clustering system, you need to provide a token in order to communicate all the members of the cluster. Or you can group the cluster members by using different tokens, right? So this SID here is very important. You need to save this token to somewhere in order to use feature commands. So we are saying that we will create a cluster. So we need a master member for the cluster, and all the other ones will be the slave. You can set up several masters, but in our session, we will use only one master member. In order to create a master swarm member, you actually create a machine, same command, Docker machine, create, and then I am providing the driver, VirtualBox. With those three parameters, I am saying that -- swarm means this machine will be a member of the entire cluster. And the second parameter, swarm master, -- swarm master means that this member is the master, this member is the king. And then third optional parameter is swarm discovery in order to provide token that I have already returned in the previous slide. And the final one is the name of the master member. This is, we have created master member, so we are ready to create slave members. We are, in same way, we are creating the slave member by using VirtualBox driver. We are saying that this is a swarm member. I am providing that same token here also. And I am saying that this slave member has will have a name called swarm agent 00. We have created our swarm members. So if you connect to master member of the swarm and execute the Docker PS command to see how many processes is currently working on, you will see two processes belongs to container. One of them is the swarm join. That means this agent will report their data to the swarm master, but it is a swarm master also itself. And another process is the management container process. Swarm master will have internal API in order to make you connect them and listen real-time events. For example, you are constructing a cluster mechanism, and there is a master process inside the master member inside your cluster. So I am able to listen this master in order to, whenever you run a container, master process will know that a container is up. So I can listen and take necessary actions in order to with specific actions. So if you connect to the one of the slave machines and see how many container processes working on, you can see one process, because the slave members does not have management process. They only one agent process to report their actions to the master process, master member. So this is a simple swarm relay network. You can see that there is a swarm master member at the center of the network. I have created two members in the DigitalOcean, three members in AWS. So by using just only my laptop, I am able to manage all the members inside this network. I don't need to connect to the DigitalOcean droplet or AWS instance to install something or configure some application. That's all for the theoretical information about Docker and related technologies. We will have a demo at the end of the session, but let's have a look at the architectural design about the demo. We will have three components in our architectural design. One of the components is Docker Gen image. Second one is Nginx. I think you have already heard about the Nginx. We will use the Nginx for reverse proxy, load balancing. And the final one is a simple Node.js application that prints hello world text with specific postman. I have already pushed all my Docker project to my GitHub account. I can provide the URL to whoever wants. DockerGen image generates config files by using container metadata. DockerGen is able to generate centralized logging, log rotation, reverse proxy configs, and service discovery. In this session, we will use reverse proxy configs in order to listen swarm master member and generate config file for Nginx load balancing. In order to use this image, you need to build your own image first. I have already mentioned about the project, Docker project, in my GitHub account. When you pull my project and run this command will be built an image called DockerGen and will use a Docker file inside the DockerGen folder. In order to run this image, you can use Docker run command here as a daemon. Here, I want to mention about some options here in run command. --- restart equals always means that whenever your Docker gen image is down, it will automatically goes up. Because if you do not make it up automatically whenever it's down, you are not you will not able to listen swarm master member and you will not able to generate your specific config files. So this image is very important. You need to make it up always. I am saying that the name of the this image will be DockerGen, and the third option is very important also. Here a specific environment variable Docker underscore host. This is the IP of the machine that Swarm Master member is, exists. So DockerGen image will use this IP to listen and take necessary actions according to events. So we have built our DockerGen image and run our DockerGen image. So the turn is to Nginx. There is also a general command here, docker run dash d, and restart always same for this. And I am saying that the name of this container will be Nginx, and I am exposing the 80 port to the outside of the container because I will access this container by using this IP, this port, sorry. And I am saying that volumes from DockerGen Nginx. Currently, if you have ever run a Docker command, maybe you have already used the volume property. By using volume, you can share folder information between container to your host computer. But in same way, you can share folder information from container to container. Here I am saying that I have already run the DockerGen image, and when I running this Nginx image, I am sharing the DockerGen folder structure to the Nginx. So whenever DockerGen regenerates the config files, Nginx also will know the files are regenerated and refresh itself. This is a sample load balancing config of the Nginx. There is an upstream section here. I will mention this part in later sections. So this upstream have two members in same machines but different ports. This config means that if you make a request to api.nodejs.com, your request will be auto-balanced to those IPs specific port. The main reason here is I have a Node.js application and I want to scale this application to the infinity. Whenever I run this container, my container size will be grown, and whenever run your container, the container IP will be automatically inserted display because DockerGen will know the already run container and get specific IP and port and generate the Nginx.balancer config. And our Node.js application is a simple Express.js application. Simply prints the hello world text and the specific host name. In this section, I want to mention about this parameter vhost. Vhost means here, when you run this container, it will automatically group into the Nginx reverse config by using this domain name. You can, for example, run 50 containers by using this domain name. And when you make a simple request, this domain name, your request will be automatically balanced to the 50 instance of your Node.js application. This is a simple diagram of how the kernel system works. This is my local laptop. Whenever you run a container, your container will be automatically put into the Swarm Agent 1 machine. And Swarm Master will be fire an event that a container is up, and the those are the information of the already run container. So DockerGen is already listening to Swarm Master, and DockerGen will automatically create the necessary config files, and load balancer, other hand Nginx, will automatically refresh its config. I I run another container, and that container info will automatically put into the load balancer configs, and the rest of the system like this, works like same. So we have 12 containers running, and those containers we automatically assign to specific machines. By the way, while we are using Docker Swarm has some strategies about assigning the containers to the machines. By default, it is spread. Spread means, let's say that you are playing a card game and you are putting cards each member one by one. So the first container will go this machine, and second is second one, third one is this long Swarm master. So we have a demo, but I wanna show you the steps of how we construct the entire Swarm cluster. I have already said that I will give you some comments. Some part of the comments exist here, so let me explain you how the overall process goes. Docker machine and local. I am saying here that okay. Here I am saying that Docker machine create driver VirtualBox local. I am creating a machine called local. Its name is local. Here I am saying that eval command switch my environment variables according to local machine. You may have several machines inside your computer. Let's say you have 50 machines in your local computer. So I wanna switch my environment variables according to machine which has a name local. So I am now inside the local machine. When I run this command, docker run swarm create, I am creating a swarm cluster, boilerplate. And after creating this cluster, I will return this token. So keep this token safe. And then I am creating a machine, which is a swarm master, and I am providing the token. And the name of this member is swarm master. And then Docker machine create a second member here. Okay. This time, I am switching to the Swarm master because I am gonna do some management things. First of all, I am building the Docker gen image. You need to pull the repository first. I am running the Docker gen, so Docker gen is up. I am building Nginx and I am running Nginx. Nginx also is up. So at the end of the section, I am running a sample Node.js application here. My hostname is api.nodejs.com. I am providing my image name. I am saying that always restart the container whenever it goes down. So I am exposing the port 33,000 because in my application I have exposed the 3,000 port, and my application container's name will be API1. Let me show you the machine list first. You can see that I have several machines, and three of them, Swarm Agent 1, Swarm Agent 2, and Swarm Master. I have stopped the Swarm Agent 2 because of the insufficient memory. So I have Swarm Agent 1 and Swarm Master inside my cluster. So let me switch to the Swarm Agent 1, for example. I am inside the Swarm Agent 1 right now. When I issue Docker PS, I will see that there is two container process, Nginx and Dockergen, and the third one is Swarm Join. I have already said that there is one process for the reporting to the Swarm Master member. When I switch to the Swarm Master machine, and there is no process here. This time, I can see the information, overall information about the entire cluster with Docker info command. Okay, do this one master. This time, I am saying that Docker machine restart Swarm Agent 1. This will restart the Swarm Agent 1 because when I switch my internet sometimes, I am not able to see the all the members of the cluster. I am seeing that there is only one member here, Swarm Master, but there should be another member called Swarm Agent 1. Let me restart the container machine in order to take effect. Okay, it says that machine restart. If you have any question, you can ask, by the way.
Yes, I understood. Swarm is an alternative to Kubernetes, or is it true?
Yes, that's true, but this is native solution for the Docker.
What are the pros and cons?
I do not have all the pros and cons, but if you have any problem with the Kubernetes, Docker team will not be able to help you provide you the exact solution. But if you are using Docker Swarm, you have the related technology, so it is very easy to fix your problem.
Does it have any user interface to manage the...
There is only one project called Swarm UI, but I also started another project, Docker Swarm UI, and my aim is to generate an administrative dashboard by using Swarm Master API. So if anyone interested here in contributing that project, we can develop that project together. But there is no administrative dashboard currently developed by the Docker team, but I think there is one called Swarm UI. It has a simple UI for managing the cluster members inside the Swarm cluster. Okay. As you can see, there are two members, Swarm Agent 1 and Swarm Master. In this time, we can see that we have five containers in total. You can see the screen, right? Okay, cool. We have eight images. This is primary role because I am in management mode. You can see that the strategy, cluster strategy, is spread So when I run a container, it will be distributed by spread strategy. And you can see the information about the specific Docker machines. For example, in Swarm Agent 1, the IP address is this, and this one is the port of the internal port for the API. You can see the CPUs, reserved memories, and the operating system information here. I am tailing the log of the logs of the Dockergen image. Here you can see the watching Docker events. Dockergen image container currently listening to Docker Swarm master. So let me create a container, run a container. When I say Docker PS, it gives me an error. Are you sure the Docker daemon is up? Why this error occurs? Because I am not inside any Docker machine. So I need to switch a specific machine. Let's say that I am switching to the Docker Swarm master. I am inside the Docker Swarm master member. So let me run a Node.js application. So I am here saying that I will run a container which has a name API1-2. I will expose 3000 port, and these application properties will automatically put into Nginx config in this vhost upstream. So when I run this container, you will see the token, and you will see that there are lots of logs here. In this command, I am doing SSH into the Nginx container. You can see here, the run container information automatically pushed into the upstream. So let me run another container. You can see the information here. When I run the container in the Dockergen, you can see that received event start for container, blah, blah, blah. This is the host name of the run container. So generated file into the sites enabled reverse proxy from two containers. Let me run. Okay. Okay, what's her name? Ekan is saying that, is there any specific application inside the Dockergen image? Yes, there is a Dockergen project that has a responsibility to generate specific config files. There is actually an application inside Dockergen, and it generates config files for reverse proxy config, for example, for Nginx, and there are lots of properties for that. There is a running application inside the container. It listens to Swarm Master API.
Is that a component of
Docker? No, it's a third-party application. There is an open source application. You can use it as a standalone application.
The name is
Docker-Gen. Docker-Gen. Okay. So we have time. Have you time? Another part here is I run the container of the Node.js application, and the application Node.js container automatically pushed into the Swarm master here. Swarm master AP 1.2. Swarm Master has put my application container into the Swarm Master machine automatically. So let me run another container. This time, hostname will be API blah blah blah, and let's say they API 11. You can see that in this section upstream, there are two members. Whenever you make a request to this hostname or domain name, your request will be automatically balanced to the to those servers. Let me run a couple of containers more, and I will see how to use this on the browser. This time I am seeing that this container will be grouped under the api2.modjs.com. Sorry, this will be the dash dash name is the optional name. You, if you do not provide a name, it will auto-generate some funny names. Maybe you have heard about that. Okay, let me show you the... You can see that there is another section here, upstream, and there is only one member. This is the public port. There are two types of ports inside the containers. One of them is listening in the internal side of the container, and another one is the public one. When you make a request to this port of this IP, actually this port will be auto-generated to the 3000 inside the container. Actually, all of these ports, here and the above ones, will automatically convert it to the 3000 inside the container. Let me run another container. You can see also here there are two members, right? So I have two domain names, api1.nodejs.com and another two. So those are not the real domain names and subdomain names. So I need to put those names in my etc host files. Before doing that, in order to put those domain names in my host file, I need to provide IP name of the domain. So IP will be the Docker machine of the that Nginx already running in. When I issue Docker PS command, you will see that Nginx exists in Swarm Agent 1. So I need to provide, when you say Docker machine IP Swarm Agent 1, you will get the IP address of the specific machine. And okay, I have already configured it. So if I open browser and you can see that there is a hello world and the host name inside it. And when I refresh the browser, you will see that it will load balance between two containers. Because of the default algorithm of the load balance is round robin, it will go the first one and the second time another. So when I say API2 it will go between those containers. So there are four members, two members grouped into API 1, and another two members grouped into API 2. I have said that we will talk about infinite scalable system, but infinite means here is infinite is bounded by your resources. How much do you have resource? You can automatically scale your application to that infinity. So you are the developer and you are writing code. I think you have developed such a system by using that project. That is all on my side. So if you have any question.
Swarm machine or Docker machine?
Docker machine.
Docker machine is a replacement for Ubuntu Docker, right?
It is not the same thing, but when you create a machine by using Docker machine create, it will create a machine and put Ubuntu Docker image inside the machine.
Ah, okay.
So if you have any other question, thank you so much for coming to my session.